I did these three brass inserts using the same soldering iron. Now, we can make them straight and flush to the surface every time, even inside of our prints. So stick around, because I didn't use anything expensive, just a cheap soldering iron. And you don't even need to buy the special tips. You can make your own in 5 minutes. And you can find the links for the materials in the description. Of course, you can screw things directly to your 3D printed parts, but these inserts got so cheap that I'm using them all the time. I'm not talking about these here, those are for injection molding. Don't buy this type, they are tricky to push straight and centered, and the grip is not that good. These are the ones for 3D printing. They are easier to insert and the grip is way better. So kits are very nice, they come with lots of different sizes, but the problem is that each size has only 30 pieces of them, sometimes even less. Look, this quarter inch screw, it's the size of camera mounts, but it only comes with 5 pieces. So I prefer to get bags of 100 pieces with my favorite size, which is an M3. You can use any soldering iron. The brand doesn't matter. There are two important things. The first is temperature. So get an iron that you can set the temperature. Digital is even better, and you can find them as cheap as 12 bucks. The second thing is the tip. You can use a regular soldering tip, but they are conical and you don't even need much force. The inserts get stuck to the tip. So here is a proper set of tips for brass inserts. They are straight, so they push down, guiding the insert, and they leave the insert there. But you can make your own tip in 5 minutes. The idea is to get a normal soldering tip and turn it into this. And if you have a worn-out tip, even better. This one was trash anyways. I used my drill as a lathe and shaped the tip with a file. It's not difficult. But if you are not comfortable with power tools, just buy a set of tips, they are not expensive. I made the tip thin enough to get inside my M3 inserts, making it as straight as possible. Here's an M3 insert tip from Amazon. And this is my soldering tip reshaped. And that's what I always used. I bought this tip set yesterday, just to show you here. Subscribe. So let me show you my two techniques for making inserts really flat, especially when the inserts go inside. I set the temperature to 240 Celsius. By the way, if you hold one of the buttons when you turn it on, you can change between Celsius and Fahrenheit as many times as you want. The wrong way to do it is to push it all the way in. It's wrong because it won't be perfectly flush. It leaves a melted bump around on the plastic. And because we are doing it by eye, some will get twisted and there is no easy way to make them straight. Here is the right way to do it. Push it slowly, but don't go all the way in. When the second ring of grooves start to sink in, take the iron out and quickly turn the part upside down against the table. This is a working table. You shouldn't be doing this on your beautiful dining table. The brass insert is still hot, plastic is still melted, and when you push it flat against the table, that will finish the job, and the insert will get in perfectly flush. Even when it gets a bit inclined, the table just makes it perpendicular. Straight up again. Come on, it deserves a like. This technique works great for holes that are accessible outside on the surface. But here, or here, and here, it's different. They are inside. For that, I have a secret tool. Let me show you. The bolt had some information here, so it was not flat and smooth. So I sanded the head, and that's all I changed. Let's place the insert. Gently pushing it with the iron, almost to the end, and squish it down with the head of the bolt, flat and straight. The boat is my favorite way now. They look flush and perfect every time. It's easy to hold, it quickly cools down the insert, but it's so massive you barely notice any temperature change. Especially for big parts, the boat is a winner. My boat isn't completely flat, actually it got a little bit convex. So if you look close enough, it actually dips the insert a little bit more inside of the part and the plastic looks tighter around. There's a chance it gets even stronger. Should I ask Dr. Igor from my tech fund to test it out? Let me know in the comments. Most of what you saw in this video were inserts I used in Arduino projects. If you never played with Arduinos before, you should give it a try. Elegoo has very nice kits, and I made a review comparing one of them to the official Arduino starter kit. If you like my work, use the affiliate links in the description, because it helps to bring food to my table. And that's it! See you soon!